Dear Patriots, before the news starts, please subscribe to our patriotic channel by clicking the subscribe button. Give us a thumbs up to this video. Don't forget to leave your opinion below in the comments section. Share the news on Facebook and Twitter so your friends see it. Thank you.
Hell yes. House Intelligence Committee just made announcement that will have Democrats freaking out. The dossier investigation is heating up. The Democratic National Committee, DNC, and the Clinton campaign were found to have funded the salacious report in a shocking Washington Post article that hit the stands on Monday. The House Intelligence Committee is on the case, announcing on Saturday that they have reached a settlement to obtain bank records from Fusion GPS, the research firm that produced the dossier. The Intelligence Committee put out a statement saying, "The parties have reached an agreement related to the House Intelligence Committee's subpoena for Fusion GPS's bank records that will secure the committee's access to the records necessary for its investigation. This is big progress from earlier this month when Fusion GPS executives said that they would plead the fifth if they were asked to testify about the firm's financials. Should you compel any of our three clients to appear at the scheduled deposition, they will invoke their constitutional privileges not to testify. Since that will be the case, we ask that the committee excuse them from appearing." Now their tune seems to be changing, and it looks like we may finally be getting to the bottom of this latest dossier scandal. The Democrats are finally getting their just desserts, one step at a time. Stay tuned, Patriots. H.T. The Hill. Chuck Grassley just ripped off Dianne Feinstein's mask with two words that set the internet on fire. Remember how Democrats are always railing on and on accusing Republicans of promoting institutional sexism that keeps women from succeeding? Well, as it turns out, they're themselves perfectly happy to keep women out of the workforce if those women don't fall in line with leftist thinking. Case in point, Colorado Supreme Court Justice Allison Eid. President Trump chose Eid to replace Neil Gorsuch on the 10th Circuit Federal Court of Appeals. Eid is a preeminent legal scholar with excellent credentials with degrees from University of Chicago and Stanford. She has served on the state Supreme Court for over 10 years and had bipartisan support from her colleagues for her appointment. This apparently didn't matter to Senator Dianne Feinstein, DCA, ranking member of the Senate Judiciary Committee, who said of Eid, "As Justice Gorsuch's replacement on the 10th Circuit, her record suggests she would echo his conservative approach to the law. Oh no. God forbid we have a conservative on the court." Committee Chairman Chuck Grassley slammed Feinstein and the other Democrats who voted against Eid's nomination, citing Democratic complaints that Republicans were being unjust when voting against Obama's female judicial nominees. "I don't want to see a double standard on qualified female nominees from different presidents." The operative words here are double standard. Democrats will advocate for women and minorities all day, unless, of course, those people end up being conservatives. Then they will stop at nothing to keep them silent and out of power. Thankfully, Eid did end up clearing the Senate judiciary and she will serve on the 10th Circuit, replacing Neil Gorsuch. But that won't be any thanks to Democrats, who all voted against her nomination in an 11-9 split. Share this out if you're tired of Democratic hypocrisy. HT Washington Times. Mike Pence just told America's troops two words that will make Kim Jong-un cry like a little baby. Vice President Mike Pence was in North Dakota on Friday and gave a rousing speech to troops stationed at Minot Air Force Base. Minot is one of our first lines of defense against North Korea as it houses 26 B-52 bombers and 150 intercontinental ballistic missiles that would have to be mobilized at a moment's notice if North Korea launched an attack. Pence's speech is as follows. "Anyone who would threaten our nation should know that America always seeks peace, but if we are forced to defend ourselves or our allies, we will do so with military power that is effective and overwhelming. and those gathered here at Minot Air Force Base will play a critical role again. Now more than ever, your commander-in-chief is depending on you to be ready, stay sharp, mind your mission, and your airmen, and be that credible deterrent that has assured the security of the American people for generations. The operative words here are be ready. Kim Jong-un is a bully. He bullies his own people, and he bullied the international community into ignoring his crimes against humanity and not ending his despotic regime immediately. The Trump administration is done appeasing this maniac, and Pence just sent out the strongest message possible: Americans will be ready to pay any price to preserve our safety and our freedom. Watch the whole speech here. This part starts at 13:30. Share this out 50,000 times so Kim Jong-un hears it loud and clear. America is on high alert and ready to do what it takes to preserve our union and world peace. H.T. The Hill. Ah. Trump kids' cute patriotic Halloween costumes will warm hearts across America. The Trump family is getting into the Halloween spirit in the most adorable way ever. Donald Trump Jr. posted a picture of the youngest three of his five kids Saturday, and their patriotic costumes couldn't be cuter. Chloe Sophia, 3, is dressed up as a policewoman. Boys Tristan Milos, 5, and Spencer Frederick, 4, are in camo dressed as soldiers. Superman and Batman are cool and all, but it is so heartwarming to see such young kids interested in emulating society's real-life heroes. The Trumps are really embracing this fun all-American holiday. President Trump hosted kids from the White House Press Corps for a trick-or-treating event on Friday, telling them jokes and handing them candy. The White House will also be hosting children from local schools and military families on Monday, October 30th, to trick-or-treat on the South Lawn. Melania Trump released a statement describing the event. During this event, trick-or-treaters will enjoy seeing the South Portico decorated in spider webs, creating a festive look and feel. There will also be bats and orange pumpkins with profiles of past presidents. Fog will fill the air, and the trees and south facade will be lit with different colors throughout the night. How fun is that? Hopefully the media doesn't try to turn it into something mean. President Trump has 9 grandkids and an 11-year-old son, so it'll definitely be interesting to see what the rest of the crew's costumes are. Love Trump? Love his grandkids' costumes? Share it out to spread some positivity on your newsfeed. H.T. Washington Examiner. Corey Lewandowski sends Hillary running to pricey lawyer after revealing worst nightmare on live TV. President Trump's former campaign manager, Corey Lewandowski, went on Fox News and ended another liberal dream. Speaking of the bombshell report yesterday that said Bob Mueller is going to charge someone as soon as this Monday, Corey mocked the media for their big dream and instead reminded them of their Clinton nightmare. The speculation is so insane right now, Lewandowski told Fox News's Fox & Friends this morning, according to The Hill. What we should be focusing on are the continued lies of the Clinton administration, the continued fallacies that they perpetuate. Correct. The Clintons have much explaining to do, and with Trey Gowdy leading the charge, there is no doubt we will get the answers. If there are bad players on the outside that had a periphery or a small role in the campaign, my guess is these charges have nothing to do with the campaign whatsoever, Lewandowski continued. There was no collusion, cooperation or coordination with Russia. He would know. After all, he only ran the whole campaign from the beginning until he was replaced, which happened after Trump won the nomination and before the convention. Then he struck fear in Hillary's heart. The dam is not breaking, he continued before adding the lethal truth: the only thing breaking is the Democrats. Share this everywhere if you agree. Trump just dropped a Saturday surprise on Michael Moore that has him hiding face in shame. President Trump is nasty dude. He doesn't back down from a fight. He is not afraid to take down Michael Moore on a Saturday. Watch what he just tweeted about him. It's so frickin' funny. In a Saturday tweet, Trump ripped Moore's Broadway show, which has been an abject failure. While not at all presidential, I must point out that the sloppy Michael Moore show on Broadway was a total bomb and was forced to close. Sad, tweeted Trump. After running for 13 weeks, the show made $4.2 million, according to BroadwayWorld.com. He thought that he would take down